In this screencast, we will look at how to convert mathematical models in the Laplace domain into a block diagram. To illustrate this, we will use the example shown on the screen, a case of two tanks presented in series where we have two separate inlet streams, one at temperature T1 entering the first tank, and one at temperature T3 from the second tank. In this problem, we are assuming that the flow rates are constant and that there is no accumulation. We have this inlet temperature T1, which can vary. So therefore, a variation in T1 can cause a variation in T2. Also entering this tank is a recycle from our outlet of the second tank, T4. Therefore, T2 can vary. We have some of the flow from the first tank entering the second tank, and we have our inlet, which is at temperature T3, which also can vary coming into our second tank. So therefore, we have four variables here, the respective temperatures. And when you conduct the energy balances, you end up with the relationships shown here. These would be functions of the volume of the tank, flow rates, heat capacities, densities, etc. But to show the point of the block diagram, we're going to ignore developing the mathematical model. The question now becomes is how do we develop a block diagram for this? So the first step that we would probably want to do is look at our variables and identify them as either input variables, output variables, or intermediate variables. So if we look at this, T1 and T3 would both qualify as input variables because they are things that can vary that are not modified by the process. T4 would be our output variable, and T2 is something which is directly affected by input variables, but is not the desired output. So therefore, T2 represents an intermediate variable. So let's start with a few basic ideas in terms of developing a block diagram. An important point to remember is the fact that a block diagram is a mathematical representation of the process. The way that the process connects to one another has to be shown in this block diagram. There is a connection between how the system physically is ordered with how the system is mathematically ordered. So because of that, generally what you try to do is have output variables on the right and input variables on the perimeter. You'd want the perimeter consistent with its location in the process. So for example, if the first thing that you see is the change of a particular input variable, going from left to right, then that should probably be located at the left-hand side. If it's a variable which comes in part way through the process, it will probably come in somewhere in the middle of the diagram and will come in from either the top or the bottom. So to show this, let's look at our equations we have here. The top equation comes from the first tank balance, and the bottom equation comes from the second tank balance, going from left to right. So there are a number of ways you can approach this, whether you start with the first equation or the second equation. Here, we'll start with the second equation, because we know that T4 is one of our output variables. So if we'll put it on the right-hand side of our diagram, and we'll indicate that this is T4. By looking at our diagram, we see that it is a sum of two separate transfer functions. So what that means is in order to get to T4, we need to put in a summing point. Since both are positive, we'll have a plus for both. T2 is an intermediate variable, so therefore we want to put that somewhere in the middle of our process, so therefore we'll keep that in this linear flow. This would be the transfer function, K3 over tau 2s plus 1, and what will come in is T2. T3 is an input variable somewhere in the middle of the process, so therefore it should exist in the perimeter. It's a good starting place. Try to put it somewhere in the top. So here, we'll have T3, and then this transfer function will be K4 over tau 2s plus 1. So if we look at this in terms of block diagram algebra, we have T2 prime times K3 over tau 2s plus 1 plus K4 over tau 2s plus 1 at the sum equals T4 prime. That is exactly what we have here. So that has taken care of the second equation. So now let's look at the first equation. It is for T2, an intermediate variable that we've already defined. So similar to the T4 relationship, we have a sum of two terms, which requires, again, a summing point, which is the sum of T1, which is one of our input variables. So since it is the first variable we see, generally we would put that on the far left-hand side. We have a block here to show that a transfer function. So that would be k1 over tau 1s plus 1. And then we have a k2 over tau 1s plus 1 times t4. The important point here is t4 is already in the diagram, so we do not want to draw something along this line. This would be incorrect because t4 is already in the process. So this is incorrect. Why? Because t4 is already located here. So you have to keep everything self-consistent with one another in order to mathematically appropriately represent the process. So what we should do instead is, since this stream represents t4, we use a branch point, remembering that a branch point, everything represents the same. So therefore, this is also t4. So we have the branch point, and then we form a block here, which would represent the relationship between t2 and t4. And we haven't reached the summing point. So therefore, looking at this summing point, we have that t1 prime multiplied by k1 over tau 1s plus 1 plus k2 over tau 1s plus 1 multiplied by t4 prime gets you to t2 prime. And that is consistent with our diagram here. So if we look at the second part of the question, we go back to what we had, is the question asked not only to turn the equations into the block diagram, but also to use the diagram to find the relationship between t4 and t1. So an important point to note here is when we're trying to find this relationship, is when we're evaluating t4 prime over t1 prime, and you're looking at how one output variable is affected by one input variable, you assume all other inputs are zero. So therefore, we have a second input here of t3. So when we do this analysis, we will ignore it. So to do this analysis, what we'll see is that we have t1 here. So we'll actually have the same relationship we developed in the first equation for t2. So we'll get the fact that we know that this term here is representative of our first differential equation. So in other words, this is t1 prime multiplied by k1 over tau 1s plus 1 plus t4 prime over k2 over tau 1s plus 1. To continue going through the diagram, it passes through a block, so therefore this k3 over tau 2s plus 1 is multiplied by both terms. The summation is no longer necessary because since t3 prime is 0, that means that this value here is 0. So therefore, when we send it through this block, that will just equal t4. So what we'll have is that k1 over tau 1s plus 1 multiplied by k3 over tau 2s plus 1 multiplied by t1 prime plus k2 over tau 1s plus 1 multiplied by k3 over tau 2s plus 1 multiplied by t4 prime, and that will equal t4 prime. So we'll gather like terms together. We end up with t4 prime over t1 prime equals this term here, the term in front of the t1 prime, divided by, we factor out the t4 prime here, that's just a 1, minus this whole term in front of the second t4 prime term. We could simplify this a little bit by getting a least common denominator for the denominator. The denominators in the numerator and denominator are going to cancel. That leaves us with a transfer function in general form. T4 prime over t1 prime equals k1 k3 over tau 1s plus 1 times tau 2s plus 1 minus k2 k3. This analysis to find this transfer function obtained the identical answer just using the equations, but for systems, particularly as the model's block diagrams get more complicated, the block diagram method will usually be easier to find relationships between input and output variables versus trying to sift through multiple equations. This screencast showed a methodology by which you can develop a block diagram from a number of equations that are used to describe a mathematical model for a process.